It was really important to me when I made this particular movie to kind of sit back and make sure that I was acknowledging what was happening, what was going on, and saying, I can't believe this. This is an amazing opportunity. I couldn't imagine ever working with half these people and the great fortune that I had. And then on top of which, literally living out my past. Because I grew up on the Sunset Strip with my father in the music business and being a huge fan of Tom Cruise and, you know, living it all. So it was kind of amazing. I remember I cried when I saw Tower Records go up. I cried like a stupid little baby, like, because that place was so pivotal in my youth. I spent so much time there, so that was crazy. And then I cried because when we first went into the interior of it, it wasn't finished, and I couldn't put my cameras anywhere. So that was a different kind of a tear, but it was crazy. I mean, this whole movie was made there. People don't even understand. This was an incredibly not high budget movie with an insanely tight schedule. Let's put it this way. I had 3 months less on this movie than I had on Hairspray to prepare and shoot. So it was crazy. Well, what we did was we kind of compiled the greatest hits of Sunset Strip, because I would have been shot and or certainly banished from the city if I tried to shut the Sunset Strip down for 6 weeks. And so we had to build it someplace in a remote location where we weren't disrupting all of mankind. And Florida has the exact same light that we have here, and it has the right palm trees, and it has a lot of the architecture. So it was great, and it was just this crazy blessing to be able to find a couple blocks that we could then transform. And John Huttman, the production designer, is a genius, and he figured that one out. But then all the interiors were built, and I'm not kidding, inside of a nightclub. Like, there was the nightclub that is the Bourbon Room, but then all the other sets were built inside of, like, dance rooms inside of a big, huge nightclub in Florida. We didn't have a soundstage. We had a nightclub. So I kept going, I don't want Tom Cruise to notice that we're actually, like, this whole set is made of glue and paper mache. So, like, he's used to really big, big movies. And so I thought, like, okay, here we go. Working with him, plain and simple, just made me a better director. You know, his level of commitment, his knowledge, his experience, and the faith that he put into me. He really loved being directed, and he listened to me, and he wasn't out there going rogue. You know what I mean? He understood that I was the guy with the story to tell, and he wanted to know how I saw him fitting into it. And so that kind of a partnership and that kind of faith in somebody with the career of Tom Cruise is surreal, you know? But we're at work, so it doesn't feel surreal. Do you know what I mean? It was sort of the after we'd wrap that I'd go like, did I just have Tom Cruise singing I Want to Know What Love Is while he's having sex on an air hockey table with Molinac? Did he just really do that? Like, so I was like, you know, I just had to process it every day. And, you know, to this day, I'm still kind of processing it, because it was a pretty dramatic experience, because I had so little time in the beginning that, you know, I couldn't choreograph it because I didn't have enough time. And so I got one of my great friends, who's a genius, Mia Michaels, to do it. And we were working 7 days a week. We would wrap on Saturday morning, because we were shooting always on a Friday night, all night, at like 8 in the morning. And then we would have to rehearse at like 4 in the afternoon. And then we would do the tech with all the lighting and all that stuff on Sunday. So we were legitimately working 7 days a week, hard. Wow. So it was exhausting. I looked like a something between a meth addict and a chorus person from a community theater production of Fiddler on the Roof by the end of the movie. It was crazy.
Mm.
I think what's going to click everybody into it is is literally the spirit, the joy, the music, and an international cast beyond compare. You know, I mean, Tom obviously has a huge international appeal. Catherine Zeta-Jones, you know, Russell Zingman, Mary J. Blige, international superstar. So I think the curiosity could really help it, on top of which the music is forever.